हाय एवरीवन, सो वेलकम बैक। तो आज की वीडियो में आई विल मेक द रोमांटिक एज फेमिलियर टू यू गाइस, एंड बिकॉज रोमांटिक एज इज सो बिग, सो आई हैव डिवाइडेड दिस इनटू टू पार्ट्स। सो इन द फर्स्ट पार्ट वी विल डू द पोएट्स, वी विल कवर द पोएट्स, एंड इन द सेकेंड पार्ट वी विल कवर द प्रोज राइटर्स एंड सम अदर माइनर राइटर्स एज वेल। बट बिफोर गेटिंग इन टू द वीडियो, इफ यू आर विजिटिंग माई चैनल फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, मेक श्योर टू हिट द सब्सक्राइब बटन एंड ऑल्सो क्लिक ऑन दैट लाइक एंड शेयर दिस वीडियो विद योर फ्रेंड्स। So this romantic age will be very helpful to you guys for the upcoming KVS exam. If you are giving the exam from the background English, so this will be helpful for your TGT and PGT English. So enough of talking, let's just move forward into the video. So romantic age, this is primarily for 1798 to 1837. It is also known as age of industrialization, and industrialization is resulted in unemployment because this was the age when industries were started growing. There was a new flow of writers were coming, rise of middle class, and also there was this French Revolution in 1789. In the words of William Wordsworth, we see bliss was the dawn to be alive. And French Revolution, it propagated the views equality, fraternity and liberty. Walter Pater, who is a very famous writer of this age, called it a strange beauty. Goethe, the follower of classics, said romanticism is disease, classicism is health. Walt Dunton said renaissance of wonder. Industrial Revolution and social misery, impact of French Revolution. There were two reform acts, which was 1807 and 1832. It is also known as agrarian reform. And let us just read very few characters of romantic literature. It is the subjectivity. They consider themselves as individual, as subjects. Second generation poets are highly subjective poets. Liberalism in this style, no imitation. They used to write according to themselves, no copying from anyone, and they used to write in free verse. The Wordsworth, and if you see Keats, they just used to write in free verse. And supernatural elements, imageries, especially in the poems of Coleridge, we find the supernatural elements. So this has to be one of the major characteristics of romanticism. And love for nature, obviously we know love for nature. And Keats was the only one who was not influenced by French Revolution. Other than him, William Wordsworth, Coleridge, they were, especially William Wordsworth, they were affected by the influence of French Revolution to a very, very good extent. So let us now read about William Wordsworth. So, his lifespan is from 1770 to 1850, and he was inspired by William Taylor, his teacher. He became the poet laureate in 1843 after Southey. He was the true poet laureate, and Browning called him lost leader, because it so happened that Wordsworth, first of all, he said that I will not accept poet laureateship because I want to be free, I want to be an individual. But later on he accepted. That is why Browning called him lost leader. And his uncle Raisley Caval left him £900. He took the money and went on a trip. And the very first works are from his college time. It is the Descriptive Sketches, 1793, and Evening Walk. And he was very inspired by French Revolution in 1791. He went to France and he married Annette Vallon. And it is also suspected that he has a daughter from this wife. And he used to participating in underground meetings. And he left France. He met Coleridge in 1795. And both decided to write lyrical ballads. So this was the very first commencement of romantic era. And we also find Dorothy Wordsworth and Coleridge, they formed a group. And romanticism is also known as the Magna Carta of romanticism. Lyrical ballad is also known as the Magna Carta, which is the very important part of the constitution. Coleridge and Wordsworth didn't meet in 3 years, and after that Wordsworth married Mary Hutchinson. And now let's come to the lyrical ballads. There were some poems which were written by Coleridge as well, and the most of the works were by the Wordsworth. So I will just read out the works by Coleridge, and the other works you can just note it down. He wrote Foster Mother's Tale, The Nightingale, Rhyme of Ancient Mariner, France and Ode. And Wordsworth wrote Simon Lee, VR7, Lines Written in Early Spring, expostulation and reply, the tables turned, the thorn lines composed a few miles above Tintern Abbey, and strange fits of passion I have known. The second is Immortality Ode. This is written in 1807. He wrote 518 sonnets, and these were small lyric poems. Then Solitary Reaper, bore the music in my heart, melodious music with tragedy. So I'm just giving you the brief, not going into detailings. The world is too much with us, and here he says world is really materialistic and we are surrounded by pleasure, we have forgotten nature. And there is a very famous line which he said in this poem, which is, I want to be a pagan in pantheism. Now he wrote Rainbow. I hope you must have also heard about this poem. He says, my heart leaps up when I see a rainbow in the sky, child is the father of the man. And then he wrote Upon Westminster Bridge. He described the beauty of London, Thames, and he says that now Thames is really polluted, and he is describing the morning scene here. And the seventh one is the London. He criticizes London for being corrupted and materialistic. And mind you, London has been written by three more other poets: William Blake, Samuel Johnson, and now William Wordsworth. So these three who have written about London. An idiot boy. Johnny Foe is the idiot boy. He is a school dropout, so he wrote about him. The Goody Blake and Harry Gill. And the famous poem, Prelude, he wrote, and the subtitle was The Growth of Poet's Mind. It is written in 1805. It has 13 books, published in 1850 with 14 books. Now this was a poem to Coleridge. This and it is also said that he could not get it published. Like, he had written so many poems, but at last he just published it somehow. But he wanted to be it like a epic, but it did not happen. Book 9 deals with French Revolution. Book 10 again French Revolution, and basically he's talking about French Revolution here. And now we see daffodils. When oft in my coach I lie in pensive mood, they flash upon my inward eye, and my heart dances with the daffodils. Now Peter Bell, third is by Shelley, but he wrote Peter Bell, and there are many more works. You can just take a look. I'm not going through it, otherwise the video will be really, really long. Now let us talk about Samuel Taylor Coleridge, and his time period is 1772 to 1834. He was inspired by German philosophy, and he had bipolar disease. My friend, bipolar is a disease like 6 months you become very happy and 6 months you become really sad. So Samuel Taylor Coleridge has had that, and physicians suggested to take opium to avoid pain, but he used to take opium and he became really addicted, and he became physically deformed. Monody on the Death of Chatterton, this is the very first poem he wrote, and then the second one is the Kubla Khan, which is really again very important, and Xanadu among the Desert Mirage. Under the influence of opium, he had a dream vision here, and he is reading Purchase Pilgrimage in this book, and he started penning it down. In the dream, he saw the man from the Porlock. He came and he visited, and this work left really unfinished. So let me know if you want to see any of the text in a descriptive manner. I would love to do that. Then he wrote Christabel, and then again he wrote The Rime of the Ancient Mariner, again one of the very important works by him. In 1834, there is an albatross, which is a good omen. It's a bird, but one sailor kills it. They all freeze, breathing but not alive. Game of death, life and death. And there's a famous line, water, water everywhere, not a drop to drink, all the ships shrink did. So that means there was a bird, this albatross, but the sailor, he killed this bird. And this bird, like, it is known as a very good omen. But when he killed the bird, he became the villain in the eyes of the other sailors. Then France and Ode, effects of French Revolution, as I told you. Dejection and Ode, it is for Dorothy. Who was William Wordsworth's friend. Oh lady, we receive but what we give. And also about Pantisocracy Society, where Coleridge and Southey had a dream to establish this society like utopia. Seven families to establish, brought land for making this, but it was a complete failure. And man proposes, God disposes. Coleridge marries Southey's sister-in-law, Sarah Hutchinson, to execute this plan. Then we see lectures on Shakespeare, only prose work by Coleridge, praised tragic characters. Remorse, a play in Elizabethan style, and Watchmen, it's a newspaper of Coleridge. Now comes P.B. Shelley. It's 1792 from 1822, and he wrote pamphlet against religion. So from a very early age, he used to write pamphlet against religion. He was an atheist in true sense. He had a co-writer, T.J. Hogg, and all of these things. Now, the very first poem we will see here is the Ode to West Wind. It is published in 1820. He used terza rima here. It's a three-line couplet invented by Dante. ABA, BCB, CDC. Revolution spirit celebrates power of might, West Wind, and calls it preserver and destroyer. Arrival of wind, the change has come. Scatters the wave, nature can create and destroy. The gist of this poem is, so this is the line, just you can note it down if you want. Oh, lift me as a wave, a leaf, a cloud. Then he wrote Ozymandias. It's an image of a king, two poems written by his friend. I met a traveler from an antique land. Now, Ode to Skylark celebrates the beauty of Skylark, as says, as flesh, as he was, compares himself with Skylark. A cloud, philosophical views of reform. Prometheus unbound. Prometheus was a demigod and he stole fire from the mountain. So, this is basically about that. Mask of Anarchy, it's a political poem. First example of non-violent resistance. Then he wrote Adonis. And in this poem, he paid an homage to Keats and Chatterton. The Revolt of Islam, a fight of people living in Middle East, and Elasto, the subtitle is Spirit of Solitude, Queen Mab, subtitle a philosophical poem, The Witch of Achilles, and Cain, deals with first murder on East, closet drama. It's a closet drama, it is only meant for reading. Now, a member of his visionary society were Mary Shelley, Byron, Leigh Hunt, and Thomas Love Peacock. Now comes the great writer John Keats, 1795 to 1821, and he died of tuberculosis. And by the way, Shelley died of drowning in the river, in the sea basically. Died of tuberculosis, family history. He had a family history of tuberculosis. So just take a note of all these lines. These were really important lines from his poems. Now comes the works. So Hyperion. It's a fight of gods and titans. Titans are the demigods and surrender to God unknowingly and acceptance of beauty. So guys, I'm just going through the works just to give you an idea. If you want a detailed version, you can just tell me. Eve of Saint Agnes, Lamia, Isabella, Endymion, La Belle Dansaint's Mercy. And on first looking into Chapman's Homer, he translated Iliad in 1616. Ode to Melancholy, Ode to Grecian Urn, Ode to Psyche. And he was also, he popularized the concept of negative capability, which is very similar to the T.S. Eliot's objective correlative. So yeah, both of them are really similar. So if poetry doesn't come naturally, it should not come at all. Poetry is hike on Adam's dream. The robot should not mix own emotions. The poet should not mix his own emotions. Now comes Robert Southey. He is 1774 to 1843, and he wrote The Battle of Blenheim in 1704. The Inchap Rock, Thalaba the Destroyer, Curse of Kehama, The Vision of Judgment, Joan of Arc. Now comes George Byron. He's also known as George Gordon Byron. He was physically deformed and he was the favorite of ladies. He had a very bad reputation. And the first we were dealing here is the Hours of Idleness, English Bards and Scottish Review. Again, very important. It was the reply for Edinburgh Review, Childe Harold's Pilgrimage, and Hebrew Melodies, Maid of Athens, The Prophecy of Dante, The Vision of Judgment, Don Juan, Soul of Dark, She Walked in Beauty, When We Two Parted. So these are the works by George Byron. And also there is this one more work, The Heaven and Earth. So now I will, in next video, I will discuss the minor writers and the prose writers. I hope this was helpful. This was a very generic view of the Romantic age. If you want in detail, let me know in the comment section. I will love to make it. So yes, I'll see you in the next video. Hope this helped you guys.